Students, today I am going to teach you the some topics of chapter real number. Topic is third. What is mean by third? If n is an integer number greater than 1, n is the integer greater than 1, and if a is the positive real number and nth order of a is x, then it is written as x raised to n is equal to a, or nth root of a is equal to x. If n is the integer greater than 1, a is the positive real number and nth root of x a is x, that is x raised to n is equal to a, or nth root of a is equal to x, then in this, if a is positive rational number, nth root of a is x, and if x is an irrational number, then this x is called as the third, that means nth root of a is equal to x, and x is an irrational number, it is not a rational number. If it is an irrational number, then it is called as third. Then in a third, nth root of a, this symbol is called as a radical sign, n is called as the order of the third, and a is called as the radical. In a third, nth root of a, this symbol is called as radical sign, and n is the order of third, and a is called as the radical. Then similar third or like thirds. In the simplest form, what is the simplest form? That means if the given thirds are given, then it can be simplified. Then in this simplest form of the thirds, if the order of the third and radical are equal, then the thirds are called as similar thirds. For example, 3 root of 2 and 5 root of 2. In this both, the radical sign and order of this radical is third are same, and therefore these 3 root of 2 and 5 root of 2, these two thirds are called as the like thirds. If in the simplest form of the thirds, if the order of the thirds and radical are equal, then thirds are called as the similar thirds. For example, here we take 3 root of 2 and 5 root of 2, that means in this radical is 2, order is also 2, and therefore both the thirds are similar thirds or like thirds. Again, we take next topic, comparison of thirds. What is mean by the comparison of thirds? Two thirds are given and we have to compare which is greater and which is smaller. Let A and B are the two positive real numbers, and if A is less than B, then A square is also less than B square. By using this property, we can compare the given thirds. If A and B are two positive real numbers, and if A is less than B, then A square less than also B square. And this, by using this property, we compare the thirds. For example, we take the thirds, two thirds, 6 root of 2 and 5 root of 2. For comparison, we take firstly 6 root of 2, and order of this third is 2, and therefore we write this third 6 in third by taking the square, because order of this third is 2, therefore we take the square of 6 into 2, square of 6 is 36, 36 into 2, square root of 36 into 2, that is root of 72. Similarly, for second third, order is 2, therefore we write in third 5 root of 2 as square of 5, this 5 can be written as square of 5 in third and into 5, square of 5, that is 25, 25 fifths are 125, root of 125. Now from this, we take the radicand 72 and 125. In this, 72 is less than 125, that means square root of 72 is also less than square root of 125, and root of 72 is the value of 6 root of 2, and root of 125 is the value of 5 root of 2, and therefore root of 72 is less than root of 125, that means 6 root of 2 is also less than 5 root of 2. Or it can be written as 6 root of 2 bracket square, square of 6 is 36, square of root of 2 is 2, that is 36 2s are 72. Similarly, square of 5 root of 5, that means 25 into 5, 25 fifths are 125. From this, 72 is less than 125, and therefore 6 root of 2 is less than 5 root of 2. Next topic is rationalization of third. If the two thirds are given and their product is a rational number, then the Each third is called as the rationalizing factor of the other third. For example, root of 2 and root of 8, these two thirds are given. And if we take the product of both, root of 8 into root of 2, root of 8 into root of 2, that is root of 16, and square root of 16 is 4, and 4 is a rational number. That means the product of the two thirds is a rational number, and therefore root of 2 and root of 8 both are rationalizing factor of each other. Root of 8 and root of 2 are rationalizing factor of each other because their product is a rational number. Second example, suppose find rationalizing factor of root of 18. Root of 18 can be written as root of 9 into 2, square root of 9 is 3, 3 root of 2. Now we have to find one third whose product with 3 root of 2 is a rational number and which is same root of 2. Therefore, multiplied by root of 2, 3 root of 2 into root of 2, 3 into root of 2 into root of 2, 2, 3 to the 6, and 6 is a rational number. Therefore, root of 2 is the rationalizing factor of root of 18. Then we take the examples of practice set 2.3. First example is state the order of thirds given below. What is the order? Nth root of A is equal to x, then n is the order, and that means the number or digit in the symbol of this radicand, that is v, the number written in this v type, then it is called as the order. Here cube root of 7, that is 3, is the order of the third. Here 5 is not in the v shape, and therefore it is a separate number, and therefore square root of 12, and if it is not given here, number is not given or digit is not given, then the order be taken as 2. Fourth root of 10, that means order is 4. Here root of 39, number is not given, therefore order is 2. Now cube root of 18, here 3 is given, therefore order is 3. Then state which of the following thirds are thirds justified. Which numbers are said to be the thirds whose on simplification we can get the rational number, then it is not a third, and if it is an irrational number, then it is a third. Here cube root of 51, 51 is not the cube of any number, and therefore it is a third. Now fourth root of 16, fourth root of 16 can be written as 16 raised to 1 upon 4. 16 is the fourth root of fourth power of 2 raised to 1 upon 4. 4, 4 gets cancelled, that means 2. Here 2 is a rational number, therefore it is not a third. Then fifth root of 81, 81 is not the fifth power of any number, therefore we cannot solve it, and therefore it is a irrational number, therefore it is a third. Now square root of 256, square root of 56 can be written as 256 raised to 1/2. 56 is the square of 16, therefore square of 16 raised to 1/2, 2 gets cancelled, remaining is 16, and 16 is a rational number, that means it is not an irrational number, therefore it is not a third. Cube root of 64, cube root of 64 can be written as 64 raised to 1 upon 3. 64 is the cube of 4, that means cube of 4 raised to 1 upon 3, 3, 3 gets cancelled, remaining is 4, and 4 is the rational number, and therefore it is not a third. Now square root of 22 upon 7, we cannot find the square root of 22 upon 7, therefore it is a third. This is the second example. Next example is classify the given pair of thirds into like thirds or and unlike thirds. Now firstly, which thirds are said to be like thirds? The thirds having equal order and equal radicand are called as the like thirds. In a pair of thirds, if the order of the thirds and their radicand are equal, then the thirds are like thirds, otherwise they are unlike thirds. For that, firstly we have to simplify the given pair of thirds. Now root of 52, order of this root of 52 is 2, therefore factorize it as one number is perfect square, that means the factors of 52 are 4 into 32. If we factorize 2 into 26, 4 into 13. In this, there is no any number which is perfect square. Therefore, we take 4 and 13. 4 is the perfect square. And therefore, square root of 4 is 2 and root of 13 as it is. Second, third is given 5 root of 13. Now, if we see in this pair of third, the radical are same. Its order are also same. And therefore, order and radicand of thirds are equal, and therefore given pair of thirds is like third. Then second, root of 68 and 5 root of 3. Root of 68, again order is 2, therefore factorize it. Suppose 2 into 34, 3 is not divided by 68 is not divided by 3, 4, 17. Now again 4 is the perfect square. Therefore we take 4 into root of 17, root of 4 into 17, square root of 4 is 2, 2 root of 17. Second number is, third is 5 root of 3. Order is same, but radicand are not same, and therefore order of third is same, but radicand are different, and therefore the given pair of thirds is unlike third, or we can directly turn as these are the unlike thirds. Then next, 4 root of 18 can be written as 4 into 9 into 2. Square root of 9 is 3. Therefore, 4 into 3 into root of 2. 4 threes are 12. 12 root of 2. Now, second third is 7 root of 2. Now, if we see root of 2, order is same, radicand are same. And therefore, we can write order and radicand of thirds are equal. And therefore, these are like thirds, or you can write the given pair of third is a like third. Then 19 root of 12 can be written as 4 threes are 12. 19 into square root of 4 is 2. 2 root of 3, that means 38 root of 3. Second third is 6 root of 3. That means root of 3. Order and radicand are same, and therefore we can write again order and radicand of thirds are equal, and therefore these are like thirds. Then 5 root of 2 and 7 root of 33, we cannot simplify root of 22 and root of 33, because there is no any perfect square in their factors. 22 can be written as 2 into 11, 33 that is 3 into 11. Both are not perfect square. Therefore, order is same, but radicand are different, and therefore these are unlike thirds. We cannot simplify this. Then 5 root of 5 7 root of 75. 5 root of 5, it is the simplest form. Therefore we simplify root of 75. It can be written as root of 75, that is 25 into 3, 5 root of 3. That means again order is same, but radicand are different. Therefore, these are unlike thirds. Next example is simplify the following thirds. That means we have to factorize it, the radicand. that is root of 27. Root of 27, order of root of 27 is 2. Therefore, we factorize such that one number is perfect square. 9 3 is square root of 9 is 3, and therefore 3 root of 3. It is the simplest form of the third. Root of 50. Again, root of 50 can be written as 25 into 5, 2. 25 into 2, 25 is the perfect square. Therefore, square root of 25 is 5, root of 2 as it is. This is the simplest form. Root of 250. Root of 250 can be written as 25 tens are. Square root of 25 is 5, root of 10 as it is. That means we have to factorize the radicand such that one number is the perfect square. Now, root of 112. Tables 16 sevens are 112. Square root of 16 is 4. Therefore, 4 root of 7. Then 168. If tables are, we cannot remind the tables, then we can divide this. Like this, divide by 2. 162 divided by 2, that is 284. 2 into 84. 168 is not divided by 3. Therefore, divide by 4. 4 4s are 4, 2s are. Now 4 is the perfect square, therefore we simplify as 168 as 4 into 42, square root of 4 is 2, root of 42, and this is the simplification of the given thirds. Then compare the following thirds. We compare this. First is 7 root of 2. 7 root of 2, now order of 2 is, third is 2, therefore we can write 7 into third, sign of the third as 7 square into 2. 7 square into 2, that is 49 into 2. Root of 49 into 2, that is 98. 5 root of 3, again this 5 can be written as square of 5 into 3. Square of 5 is 25 into 3. Square of 25 into 3 is 75. And now from this 98 and 75, 98 is greater than 75. That means root of 80, 98 greater than 75. And root of 98 means 7 root of 2 greater than root of 75 means 5 root of 3. And that is the comparison of the given thirds. For comparing, firstly we take the coefficient of, or the number before this radicand sign. We write this number in the radicand sign by taking the square. Why we take the square? Because the order of the third is 2. If the order of third is 3, then we take the cube of that number. And therefore, and again, second example, both thirds having the same order. Therefore, we directly compare 247 and 274. From this 274 is greater than 247, therefore root of 247 is less than root of 274. Then next, 2 root of 7, this 2 root of 7 can be written as, now 2 can be written as in root square of 2 into 7, because order of third is 2, therefore we take the square of 2, 4 into 7, 4 7s are 28, therefore root of 28. Second number is also root of 28. Root of 28 is equal to root of 28, and therefore 2 root of 7 and root of 28 are equal thirds. Then next, 5 root of 5. This can be written as, now root of square of 5 into 5. Root of square of 5 is 25 into 5, that means root of 125. Then 7 root of 2 can be written as root of 7 square into 2, root of 49 into 2, root of 49 to the 98. Now from this 125 and 98, 125 is greater than 98, and therefore we can write square root of 125 is greater than square root of 98, and that means root of 125 means 5 root of 5 greater than root of 98 means 7 root of 2, and that we have to compare. Then 4 root of 42. 4 root of 42, 4 can be written as square of 4 root of 4 square into 42. 16 into 42. Now product of these 16 2 32, remaining 3. 16 4 64, 64 plus 3 67, that means 4 root of 42 means root of 672. Now 9 root of 2, 9 can be written as in root, that is root of square of 9 into 2. Root of square of 9 is 81 into 2, that means root of 162. Now from this 672 and 162, 1672 is greater than 162, that means square root of 672 is greater than root of 162. Now root of 672 means 4 root of 42, which is greater than 9 root of 2. Then next, 5 root of 3, again we can write it as square root of 5 square into 3. Square of 25, 5 is 25 into 3, root of 75, 9. Now 9 can be written as square of root of square of 9, root of 89. Now 75 and 81, from this 75 is less than 81, that means root of 75 is less than root of 81, and root of 75 means 5 root of 3 less than root of 89 means 9. Then next, similar to this, 7 can be written as root of square of 7, that means root of 49. 2 root of 5 can be written as square of 2 into 5, that is 4 into 5 and root of 20. Now from this 49 and 20, 49 is greater than 20, that means root of 49 is greater than 20, root of 20, and root of 7, 49 means 7, 7 is greater than root of 20 means 2 root of 5, and that are the comparison of the given certs. In this comparison, we take the simplification, that means we write the number before the radicand sign into the radicand sign of the radicand by taking the square. Why we take the square? Because we see the order of the third. If the order of third is 2, then we take the square. If the order of third is 3, then we take the cube. If the order is 4, then we take the fourth power of that number, and then compare the given numbers radicand and with the radicand which is greater than the second radicand. Then in this, first radicand is greater than second, and therefore we write first third is greater than second. Like this we can compare the given thirds. Next example is simplify. First is 5 root of 3 plus 8 root of 3. From this we can take root of 3 as common, that means we get 5 plus 8. 5 plus 8, that is 13. 13 root of 3. That is the simplification. Second, 9 root of 5 minus 4 root of 5 plus root of 125. It can be written as root of 5 gets common, 9 minus 4. And factorize this as 25 fifths. One number is perfect square. From this 9 minus 4, 5, 5 root of 5 plus square root of 25 is 5, 5 plus root of 5. Again root of 5 gets common, we get 5 plus 5, that is 10 root of 5. Or we can take 9 root of 5 minus root of 5 as it is, like this. This is the one method. Then second method, I take 9 root of 5 minus 4 root of 5 as it is. Now 9 root of 5 minus 4 root of 5 plus this square root of 25 is 5, 5 root of 5. Now from all these three terms, root of 5 gets common, 9 minus 4 plus 5. 9 minus 4, 5, 5 plus 5, 10 root of 5. These are the second, this is the second method. Now third is 7 root of 48 minus root of 27 minus root of 3. Now 7 root of 48 can be written as 16 threes are 48 minus 27 can be written as 9 threes are minus root of 3 as it is. 7 into square root of 16 is 4, 4 root of 3. Square root of 9 is 3, 3 root of 3 minus root of 3 can be written as 1 root of 3. 7 4s are 28, 28 root of 3 minus 3 root of 3 minus 1 root of 3. From all these three terms, root of 3 gets common. Remaining is 28 minus 3 minus 1. 28 minus 3, 25. 25 minus 1, 24 root of 3. Then fourth example, from all these terms, three terms, root of 7 gets common. Here remaining is 1 minus 3 upon 5 plus 2. This 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 3 root of 3 upon 5 root of 7. Now by taking cross multiplication, 5 3s are 15 minus 3 upon 5 root of 7. 15 minus 3, 12. 12 upon 5 root of 7. In this, we take root of 7 as common. Then here remaining is 1 minus 3 upon 5 plus 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 3 upon 5. Now by taking cross multiplication, for taking the same denominator, 3 fifths are 15 minus 3 upon 5. 15 minus 3, 12. 12 upon 5 root of 7. Then same seventh example is multiply and write the answers in the simplest form. That means firstly we simplify the given search and then write the answer. 3 root of 12. Root of 12 can be written as 4 into 3. Root of 18 can be written as 9 twos are 3 into square root of 4 is 2, root of 3. Square root of 9 is 3, root of 2 as it is. Now this 3 into 2 into this 3 and then write root of 3 into root of 2. Firstly we take the rational number nearer to each other. 3 2 is 6, 6 3 is 18. Root of 3 into root of 2, root of 6. And it is the answer of the multiplication. Then next is 3 root of 12. 3 root of 12 can be written as 4 3 is into 7 root of 15 can be written as 15 as it is, because there is no perfect square in the factors. 3 fifths are 3 is not a perfect square, 5 is not a perfect square. Therefore we cannot simplify this. Directly we take square root of 4 is 2, root of 3 as it is, into 7 into root of 15. Then 3 twos are 6, or we can write the rational number nearer to each other, into root of 9 into root of 15. Then 3 twos are 6, 6 sevens are 42 into root of 45. Now we can simplify this. 42 into 9 into 5. 42 square root of 9 is 3, 3 root of 5. 42 threes are 126 root of 5 as it is. We can simplify this. 3 into 4 root of 4 into 3 into 7 root of 15 as it is. Square root of 4 as 2. 3 into 2 into root of 3 into 7 root of 15. Now 3 into 2 into this 7 into root of 3 into root of 15. Then 3 2s are 6, 6 7s are 42 into root of 15 into 3, 45. Now 40 root of 40 can be factorized as 9 into 5. Square root of 9 is 3. 42 into 3 into root of 5. 42 3s are 126 into root of 5. Or this can be solved by another method like this. Three root of 12, that is 4 into 3. 7 into root of 15, that is 5 into 3. Then 3 into square root of 4 is 2 into root of 3 into 7 into root of 5 into root of 3. Now 3 into 2 into 7, then root of 3 into this root of 3 and then root of 5. Now product of this is 42. Product of root 3 into root 3 is 3. Root of 5 as it is. Now factor product is 126 root of 5, and this is the another method. Then here 3 into root of 8 into 5, I can take directly product. 3 into root of 40, this 3 root of 40 can be written as 4 into 10. Square root of 4 is 2, 2 root of 10, that means product is 3 2 is 6, 6 root of 10. Then root of 8 gets same, therefore we take directly 5 into 2 into root of 8 into root of 8. 5 2s are 10, root of 8 into root of 8, 8, and 10 8s are 80, and this is the multiplication. Next example is divide and write the answer in simplest form. most easy examples, root of 98 divided by root of 2. This can be written as now, root of 98 means 49 into 2 upon 2. This can be written as like this, root of 98 upon 2. 2 gets cancelled, root of 49, and square root of 49 is 7, and this is the simplest form. Then second, root of 125 divided by 50, that means root of 125 divided by 50, factorize both the numbers, 25 fifza, 25 twoza, 50, 25, 25 gets cancelled, answer is root of 5 upon root of 2, or we can write root of 5 upon root of 2. Third is root of 54 divided by 27, that means 27 twoza 54 upon 27 as it is, 27 gets cancelled, answer is root of 2. Then fourth, root of 310 divided by 5. Now we can factorize this 310 by dividing 5. 5 6 are 30 and 5 2 are 10. That is 62 into 5 upon 5. 5 5 gets cancelled. That means answer is root of 62. Then next example is rationalize the denominator. That means we have to write the denominator as rational number. For that we have to rationalize this. For rationalize, multiply and divide by the same third or irrational number in the denominator. Then here root of 5 is the irrational number, that is the third, and therefore multiply and divide by root of 5 to the numerator and denominator. That means 3 upon root of 5 into root of 5 upon root of 5. We can multiply and divide by root of 5. Then 3 root of 5 as it is, and root of 5 into root of 5, that is 5. And that is the rational number, and this process is called as the rationalization. Then here 1 upon root of 14. To rationalize this, multiply and divide by the same third in the denominator, that is root of 14 upon root of 14. That is multiply and divide by root of 14. Root of 14 as it is, root of 14 into root of 14, that is 14, and that is the rational number. Again, 5 upon root of 7, in denominator root of 7 is given, therefore multiply and divide by root of 7. Multiply and divide by root of 7. We get 5 root of 7 as it is, root of 7 into root of 7, that is 7, and that is the rational number. Then next is 6 upon 9 root of 3. Now here root of 3 is only third irrational number, therefore multiply and divide by root of 3. Multiply and divide by root of 3. We take multiply and divide by root of 3. Now 6 root of 3 as it is, 9 as it is, root of 3 into root of 3, 3, and this 6 is divided by 3, that is 2. That means we get 2 root of 3 upon 9. That is the rationalization. Then 11 upon root of 3, 11 upon root of 3. In denominator, the irrational number is root of 3. Therefore, multiply and divide by root of 3. Multiply and divide by root of 3. 11 root of 3 as it is, root of 3 into root of 3, 3. And that 3 is the rational number. And this is the rationalization, the denominator. Now to rationalize the denominator, what is the process? Multiply and divide by the irrational number or third given in the denominator. Here suppose 3 upon root of 5, root of 5 is the irrational number, therefore multiply and divide by root of 5. And after multiplying we get the rational number in the denominator, and that is the rationalization. 3 upon root of 5 into root of 5 upon root of 5, this root of 5, root of 5 gets 5. That is the rational number, and this process is rationalization. And numerator as it is, 3 root of 5. 1 upon root of 14, in denominator root of 14 is the rational number. Therefore, multiply and divide by root of 14. Root of 14 upon root of 14. Root of 14 ones are root of 14. Root of 14 into root of 14, 14. And 14 is the rational number. 5 upon root of 7. Root of 7 is the irrational number. Therefore, multiply and divide by root of 7. 5 upon root of 7 into root of 7 into root of 7. 5 root of 7 as it is. Root of 7 into root of 7, 7. That is the rational number. 6 upon 9 root of 3. Now, in this 9 root of 3, only root of 3 is the irrational number. Therefore, only we multiply and divide by only root of 3, not 9 root of 3. 6 upon 9 root of 3, multiply and divide by root of 3. 6 root of 3 as it is, 9 into root of 3 into root of 3, 3. 6 divided by 3, that is 2, 2 root of 3 upon 9. Next, 11 upon root of 3. Root of 3 is the irrational number in denominator. Therefore, multiply and divide by root of 3. Therefore, 11 root of 3 upon root of 3 into root of 3, that is 3. And that is the rational number. And that are the examples of practice set 2.3.